Can you hear me clearly or some disturbances?
I can hear you clearly.
Okay, fine. That is very important.
I can hear you.
Fine. Now I'll go to the chapter we're doing. Oh, this is 10th I have opened. You have gravity, right? I'll go to notes. Akanksha, she don't have the notes. Do you have notes of gravity?
No, sir.
So I'll send it later, or anyone can send you later. I'll email you after the class is over. Or right now also I'll try, but in between I don't know, this may create a problem. Let me see. So we in gravity we started with what? First we talked about gravity, and when we talk about gravity, we are very clear that we are talking about a force. So it's not wrong that after force chapter we are doing gravity. It's rather genuine, it's correct. Because once you know force, and for quick revision, in force we have done F equal to ma. So when we talk about F equal to ma, so we talk about gravity. And if you know the gravity chapter, I am showing you the figure again in the WhatsApp group. See the photograph of the notes, beginning of the notes. So you can see that the weightage given to the topics, what we have done so far, you should be confident also. Gravitation we know now. Gravitation is the matter mostly talking about pull between Earth and any other substance. So gravitation has three star marks. I repeatedly discussed this, again I am discussing this. And universal gravitational law of gravitation, that is having four stars, so very important. And calculation of value of G is again very important. Free fall is only two star, so sometime it may come in exam, sometime it might not. Not so important, but important. And then mass and weight, three stars. Means one problem, I think so James gave me the answer. And that was correct. I have seen in mobile actually, and that's why I have not corrected it, and I did not send back. He gave me the weight of a mass on moon. So mass and weight, not only mass and weight, it also talks about all planets mass. Suppose say my weight is 70 kg on Earth. If I go to moon taking weighing machine, how much I'll weigh there? Because small g is less in moon. So in last class we discussed in details what makes small g less. Small g is equal to capital G. Write down the formula, that will be much easy for you to understand and remember also. More you write formulas, more you do numerical, the concept will be further more clear. So small g is equal to capital G, capital M by R e square. Capital M is mass of Earth, of the planet, it can be Earth or any other planet, and R e square is radius of that planet. So bigger the radius of the planet, there is more chance to have less acceleration due to gravity, small g, but not necessary always, because mass and R square ratio gives exact value, because capital G remains same, there is no change in this. I am not intentionally giving you whiteboard and not writing the formula. Akanksha, is the formula clear to you? You write down small g is equal to capital G M by R e square, or just write R square, radius square. If you know that formula, you can mass find out, if given mass of the planet and given radius of the planet, you can actually measure anything. That is very clearly you can measure any planet and the mass in that. That is very easy for you to calculate. Now up to point 6 we have this topic, gravity. From point 7 you can see we talk about thrust and pressure. Thrust and pressure, actually we are looking to liquids and pressure in fluids. This is a very interesting topic actually, and I'll give you some very interesting incidents on the world around us and in the world, and you'll find this is very relevant. And we also have buoyancy, all from 7.7 onwards, all things dealing with liquids. There is nothing to do with gravity. There are actually two parts of this chapter. So before discussing thrust and pressure, I'd like to say about tsunami. All of you were very young that time, and 26 December, I don't remember the year, just after Christmas, next day there was a huge tsunami, and all of you were aware of this, and center was somewhat near Indonesia. But within no time, when the incident happened, it's sort of like earthquake inside sea, a huge earthquake inside sea, and that made the ocean water, the Bay of Bengal water, disturbed. And it was so much disturbed that the incident happened in near the shore of Indonesia, and within no time the Chennai, the Andhra Pradesh and Odisha coast were totally destroyed, and many people died. Because nobody knew, things were very comfortable in seashore. Early in the morning hours, many people go for morning walk in the sea beach, and they didn't know. All at a sudden, the wave of the ocean came like anything, like a giant, and washed away everything. All resorts, all hotels, all buildings near seashore were totally damaged by that high velocity ocean wave, sea wave. Now, point is this: how come this happened? If the incident has taken place in Indonesia and it could have taken a little time to come to India, then of course by satellite and all we could have make out, and we could have arranged some security measures so that the death the case would have been less, like in we have done during Amphan. Much 2-3 days, 1 week before, the continuously meteorological department of India was continuously warning all things should be removed, all should go, these, that, many things were being precaution, and people knew exactly when it will strike Kolkata, and with this knowledge they could easily save many lives. Otherwise it would have been dangerous, the Amphan, the intensity that would be. But in tsunami we could not do anything. The reason is very simple: when pressure occurs in liquid, one side of the liquid, it moves all throughout, and that is the thing is said in our typical meaning of, that is the thing. If somebody have sound, because you are at home, so you can know how to mute. Those Akanksha is new, she doesn't know, so just mute, press the mute button, and if I ask some you, if you want to say me, switch on again the mute mic button, that will work. So what happened actually, instantly the thing happened worst, but the reason is very simple. That is our Pascal law, the first concept in this topic, and which is very interesting, and amazingly this also changed our industry world. In our daily life also we know some application of this Pascal law. What is it? Suppose I won't draw anything, I'll tell you like story, and you listen to this and you remember also throughout your life. Suppose say all of you have seen normal soft rubber balls whose inside is empty. We play cricket also. Nowadays I don't see those balls. In our child days we used to have very common ball, is the rubber ball, where inside is empty, and you can actually with a syringe, with an injection, you can pour water into it. And what Pascal did initially, he took such a ball, filled it with water, and he made with needle, he made many pores around the ball, all around the ball, and then he took the ball and squeezed it in his hand with his fingers, and he found water from the ball is moving all directions. That is very interesting, and with equal force. How come? Because his fingers are not holding each and every part of the ball, rather his fingers are limited to certain part, but force given to all directions are exactly same. The water coming out from the ball with same force, same pressure. Suraj, is it clear? Suraj, please switch on the mic and tell me, is it clear? Suraj, is it clear? I'll repeat. Please, whenever you are not able to understand me, remember we are facing hurdles. In case you are not able to understand me, instantly switch on mic and tell me, sir, not able to understand, please repeat. It may happen in this type of classes, it may happen, I might be requiring to repeat. There is no harm in that. Now you can see I'm repeating so many things. Gravity, I'm taking so many classes continuously. In normal classes we don't need so many classes, but here I need, because there is some gap between you and me. You have to overcome this. Now what happened actually, when we talk about this, so I'll again repeat. There was a small ball in our time, our child is empty, inside is empty rubber ball, And now I don't know whether you play with this type of balls nowadays. I see normally you play with a very strong ball, but in our time that was very expensive. Our parents never afford to make us buy that. So we used to buy one small ball with rubber inside empty, and that was a main ball. And it used to bounce very high. Now, with that ball, if you take that ball and if you pour somehow water inside it, with an injection, you pour water and fill it with water, and then make various pores. Pascal actually did this, and make many pores around the ball, all around the ball, and then squeeze it. You press with your fingers the ball. He found, Pascal found, the ball, the water from the ball comes out fast in all directions with equal forces. That is the problem. How come all pores are having equal force? That is very serious point Pascal noted down. And he found a serious problem that he found a law depending on that. Let me show you in a whiteboard. I'll share a whiteboard with you and let me show you in a whiteboard. So he found it works in a very typical way. He found that ultimately you have one problem. Just a minute. Let me share the board with you. If board is not visible, please let me know. I'm going to share it. Is it visible? If not visible, then tell me.
Yes, sir.
Fine. So if I go to the board. They have given me indication, you are presenting to everyone, but there is some problem. Wait. Let's come. Now, you can see here, first what he did. Now things will be better. Is my sound clear to you all? So, there is a ball. I can take
yes,
a ball.
Sir.
Fine, fine.
Yes, sir.
I can take a ball like this. I can take a ball like this, empty ball, fine, and he poured this with water, and with finger he squeezed it, and he found water comes out in all directions equally. That is the problem. Water comes out in all directions equally with equal force, all with equal force. That is the problem. How come they can come with equal force? He concluded, he did some more experiment. He took a structure like this. He took a very beautiful structure like this with piston, airtight like pichkari. In Holi we play with pichkari. A piston like this. Fine. A piston like this. And then he took airtight piston which can be easily moved inward or outwards, just like pichkari in our Holi. So he took like this four such pistons. We call them piston. These are known as piston. Piston. So another piston here he took, and he pressed one, maybe this one he pressed, and he, this is F1, this is F2, we are giving force, and he found all other three are moving outwards and with equal force. That is very interesting finding, and that was used in technology. You will be surprised to know the way we are discussing this, because in real world also we use this very often. So he found that this was F2, F3 and F4, and suppose say the most interesting part he found, if this area of the piston is A1, area of this piston is A2, area of this piston is A3, area of this piston is A4. Please note this very carefully. There can be some tough numericals on this, so take it very seriously. He found that F1 is the force he is giving. He found F1 by A1 is equal to F2 by A2 is equal to F3 by A3 and equal to F4 by A4. Why I said all the forces are same? F1 you are giving and F2, F3, F4 are exactly same because he took pistons to be of same size. So this ratio remained same. So this is one of the crucial ratio he talked about, that F1, F2, F3 and F4 will be exactly same if area is same. But if area is different, there can be some changes. With this, we have developed the new process of hydraulic press in the car. I'll repeat. How much you understood? This much you understood? The ball, empty ball filled with water and squeeze it. Squeeze it means you press it with finger.
I also don't understand.
This part you understood? The water ball, empty ball you filled with water.
Yes, sir.
And you make pores all around the ball.
Yes, sir. Up to here I understood.
Now he took similar structure, more defined. Because in the ball he cannot calculate actually what is the force, what are the things. So he took some ball in a defined way, having some four pistons in it. Got my point? Is it clear now? He took some ball only. This is a ball only, empty ball, filled with water. And ball is fitted with pistons, four pistons. You can press this piston inwards, you can press this piston outwards. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Fine.
Now that means he gave force in F1. He gave force in F1. And in return he found all these three pistons are moving outwards with the same force as that of F1. First case he did that. But he incidentally took all the areas same. A1, A2, A3 and F4 are to be same area of the piston. Size of the piston were exactly same. And he found force, how much he is giving, is being distributed in all three directions. Is it not multiplication of force? If you want to design a machine with this, you press something in F1 and you distribute this in three directions. And this is the technique used in car brake, hydraulic press of car. In the car, we press the piston. A fast moving very heavy car than our capacity, we don't press very high heavy. We press only the pedal, that is F1. We are giving F1. Inside the car we have brake oil. Instead of water in the chamber, there's brake oil. You have all have seen brake oil. Little reddish color oil, very thick oil. So they give brake oil inside this and another is increasing in the other side. You can get force in different direction. So four wheels of the car, they give actually four. I'm giving you extra three, but they actually in car, they use five total. So in one you give and other four gets the force. And that force is attached with the brake, the wheel of the car. And all car are being stopped. Is it clear? Is it clear? Please say me one by one. Is it clear? You are giving here, you are getting force. Red one is you are getting. Blue one I am giving. Red one you are getting. So you get actually the force in return. Am I clear? Please say me one by one. Suraj and Shashwat, please tell me first. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Because there is no use of going ahead if you don't understand it clearly. So that means after that you talk about the... this is what our piston. First, Pascal law. We come with Pascal law. See the spelling. It's almost like rascal without R. It's Pascal law. So Pascal was the name of the scientist, French scientist, who designed it. And after him, we got so many changes in industry. This was rigorously used in industry, including car brake and all. Fine. So you get Pascal law. So Pascal law says that, listen to the statement, in notes you will get exact notes, exact statement, but let me make it more clear and easy to remember. He said, whenever you give some force to a fluid, water is also a fluid, it travels undiminished in all directions. It travels undiminished in all directions. So, when we have map of India, let's go to map of India like this. This is Bangladesh and this is Indonesia. Tsunami occurred here, but this is all filled with ocean, sea water, Bay of Bengal. So within no time, undiminished, equal intensity of force, it spoiled Indonesia. At the same time, it traveled even here and struck the entire eastern coast of India. Sri Lanka is somewhat here. Kerala was saved because of Sri Lanka. Sri Lankan eastern coast was totally destroyed like this because of the force, the travel of the waves. And again, a very interesting story. Bangladesh and southern West Bengal had less. Can you tell me why? Bangladesh and southern West Bengal had less effect. I still remember I was in Silchar only during that tsunami, and we all came out of house, and there was some water outside our house, water logging in opposite side of my house, and water was also moving. In Bengali, they call it jolatong, like bhumikompo, they call it jolkompo. This is known as jolkompo because water starts moving. Yeah, tsunami is nothing but jolkompo, means earthquake under water, and sea water is connected to the entire water of the world. So whenever the once the sea water is
not here.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me now?
Yes, sir.
So this is our Silchar. Do you think we are far off from the Bay of Bengal? We are not. About 500 kilometers far away from Bay of Bengal. But Bangladesh and entire West Bengal South didn't face that much of problem from the tsunami. Reason is very simple. The water here, we have delta, river delta here. This is a question of geography. River delta are very soft soil. They absorb shock. They use like a shock absorber. Like in a car or a bike, in bike you can visibly see a spring like structure like this. You can see in bike a spring like structure. What are these? These are shock absorber. They absorb shock when bike travels on the road, because they are quite strong, iron made, and some of the bike has got two or some of the four also. Nowadays some bike is there which has got four. So when you sit on those type of bike which has got four spring like this, which are called shock absorbers, they actually are very comfortable. You won't get tired so quickly because of the vibration while bike is moving. In bus and truck, you can see very big spring sort of thing down there in the bus. These are nothing but shock absorber, because when bus travels, there is a huge force given to the bus due to vibration of the bus, and this spring, the shock absorber, absorbs it, and it save, makes the bus platform safe. We are comfortable sitting on the car or bus, whatever it may be. So here, this water, the delta, river delta of southern Bengal makes it like shock absorber. When shock came, it was absorbed in the quicksand in the river delta. So we didn't get that much of vibration. Otherwise, it could have visibly devastated southern Bengal whole, including Dhaka and even Calcutta. Got my point? So you have to be very clear that tsunami is best example to understand Pascal law. That story happened somewhere near Indonesia, and it traveled within no time here in India. Think about your car brake. You push the brake pedal of your car, and car takes long time. If the force you are giving in pedal, this is a car pedal, brake pedal. This is our brake pedal. Very easy and interesting topic actually. This is brake pedal. We have this brake pedal, and we press this. And suppose it takes time to go to the wheels, four wheels, to stop it. Then you cannot stop your car instantly. We call it brake fail. But this happens if there is some leakage, some force disturbs, get disturbs. But normally this doesn't happen in brake. There is a brake pipe in the old car. Nowadays we have modern system, but in old car things were quite visible. There were literally pipe going to all wheels of a car. If this is your car, you have four wheels. One is here, another is here, another is here, another is here. You press your pedal here, and there is pipeline connected to this. And there is a container of brake oil. Still now we have in new cars also we have brake oil like this. So we pour brake oil, and this pipe is carrying that brake oil, and you press the pedal, that force you are giving, very mild force, that will be transferred to all four wheels and it is multiplied. And that is the secret of car brake. Got my point? I'll tell you some technical issues now, technical advantages we have used in using this pedal, how we have used them. Let me explain this now. Brahma's press, that will make it the topic more interesting and more clear to you. You'll understand it much better. Is the things visible? My sound is clear? Please tell me in case it is not clear. Don't hesitate. Immediately tell me, sir, sound is not clear.
Yes, sir. Fine. Sound is clear to me.
Fine.
Sound is clear.
Okay, fine. Now, if I go to explain Brahma's press, this is a bit high level concept, but in mostly in higher classes this is discussed. But if I don't discuss this, you get bored with this topic. After explaining and understanding this, you will get more clear picture and you can easily handle numericals. What I did actually, we call it Brahma's press, very nice name, Brahmaji's press. Brahma's press. You know, India had a bad history that British came to us and they took away all cotton from India and made clothes in Manchester and resold them. Our cotton, they took it from us at low cost and they sold us clothes at higher cost. But carrying cotton used to be a very problem because volume of cotton is very high and to carry them in ship, it was very uncomfortable. But Brahma's press helped them. And after that, Manchester rise like anything. He was a British physicist, so after his work, it worked like anything and they could shine and they could torture us more, British. Fine. Though our leaders are torturing us now more than British, that is also true, but somehow British exploited our money. If our leaders are cheating us, the money will remain within India, at least that much we are sure. But in that case, we are not sure that things are going to England. Suppose say, structure is somewhat like this. Here is a piston. Here is a piston. And, this is a big one, big chamber like this. And here we have a small chamber. It's a pipeline like this. Try to understand. This is a pipeline. Here we have a small piston. Any ABC can press this. I'll rub this part because this is a whole piston, big piston. Whole chamber is big now, and this is can this part is excess. This is extra issue. Fine. Now this is filled with water or any other liquid, maybe brake oil sort of thing. Maybe brake oil sort of thing it's filled with. So here is water. Suppose I take water. This is filled with water. Now, if I give some force and area of this one, suppose say A1, let me call it A1. And area of this one is A2. There are many numericals comes on this, so please concentrate to area and force. So I give a force here F1. This is small pedal, like a car brake. I give small force here with my capacity. But as area increases, so the force will be new, so force comes here to be F2. This is a new force. Now when I give this force, the as per Pascal law, the force transverse, F1 transverse, undiminished. Undiminished means it doesn't changes. But area is more. And in Pascal law he found a formula, F1 by A1 is equal to F2 by A2. So this is the formula he found. Now see here, very clearly it's visible. A2 is much, much bigger than A1. So you can see right very clearly here, A2 is much, much bigger than A1. But we have to maintain this ratio. Pascal law is valid even here. So if you want to maintain this ratio, if F1 is less and A1 is also less, then if F2 remains to be same, A2 is already very big. So F2 has to be big to maintain the ratio F2 and A2. Should be equal to F1 by U1. Please try to understand this. This is a bit complicated concept. To maintain the ratio, because Pascal law said F1 by A1 is equal to F2 by A2, to maintain the ratio, if A2 is very big, F2 also has to be very big. Otherwise, the value will change. Suppose say this is equal to F1 by A1 is equal to 10. So that has to be maintained. Even F2 by A2 should be equal to 10. And as you have taken A2 to be very big, F2 also has to be very big, so that the ratio remains fixed value, suppose say 10 I am taking. So this force F2 will be very big in that case. So this is chamber I drew here, and if I pour cotton in this, and if F2 comes with a very high force, it will strike the chamber, the cotton, and make the cotton tablet because of very high force, which manually we can never do. So that is the advantage. Even a thin and lean man can pour, many of them can pour cotton, huge quantity of cotton in this, and some thin and lean man can press this, and whole cotton will turn to tablet. And it's very easy to carry tablet of cotton, which is very compact, carry to England and restructure from cotton. They can make thread out of it. Even compressed cotton can be changed to thread, because huge quantity of cotton has been compressed in a button sort of thing, and then that can be reused. So they could save a huge quantity of energy and wastage of volume in the ships while carrying it. Fine. So this is how we talk about our Pascal law. You can see here, when we talk about Pascal law, we are very clear that we are talking about the transfer of force and area. That means we can do any manipulation. So far you have seen two applications of Pascal law. First, we found that is used in car brake, and second, you found in Brahma's press we are using for compressing something. Third, very useful, and you all have seen this. Third, in the car service station, if you put a car here instead of this chamber, you put a car, it's thin and lean man, and if you have set up like this in car service station, just by pressing this, a car can be lifted to a very high altitude for cleaning the downside or repairing the downside of the car. So hydraulic press, then we call it hydraulic press, by which we can lift any heavy body, even by a thin and lean man. We don't need as such very heavy person to lift a car or any other electrical support like a lift or a platform, electrical platform, anything like that. By non-mechanical thing, we can lift the car in our required height, and we can easily use this. This is the advantage of the Brahman Pascal law. So if I go back to the topic, you can see the notes. We'll discuss thoroughly. Today is the start, so in the start I don't like to go too intensive, but you by this time you have understood the seriousness of this topic, how enjoyable this topic will be. You'll find many things which are thrilling for you, and we'll talk about thrust and pressure, we'll talk about pressure in fluids, we'll talk about buoyancy, and we'll see why objects float and sink when placed on surface of water. And we also deal with Archimedes principle, and at the end we'll deal with relative density in this topic. So they all are very interesting topic, one of my most favorite topic, and you must have understood how much joyful this topic will be. But before that, I'll declare a gravitational exam maybe Monday. I'll see you in WhatsApp, and you have to handle it very carefully. I'll conclude now, and we'll continue the class later.